But dude, I know your voice, man. Your voice is incredibly, incredibly good. And I could see that I think they used like a take that was maybe less than optimal for you.
Really?
Perhaps.
नहीं ठीक है यार अच्छा है मुझे अच्छा लगा
अच्छा तो है बहुत अच्छा और how were the horses?
How were the horses का क्या मतलब
dude I
no it's crazy
I don't want to be sounding against any live living beings in the world but I can't tolerate horses. I have my experience
with them very often.
I shot with them
you shot a couple of them
many times but how was your experience?
But you know to be honest I thought it's going to be something that I don't enjoy but I actually really enjoyed the horse riding. It's really? Very dangerous when you're doing it for like your you know doing stunts and stuff. Of course that's very dangerous and when there's multiple horses together and stuff that feels very intimidating but I actually enjoyed the horse riding a lot.
Like with all
I'm actually thinking of doing it again.
The costume, the sword, how heavy was that sword?
That sword was very heavy. The costume, and we were shooting in the middle of, it was pretty much, it was the beginning of summer. So it's the beginning of summer and you have the costume, then you have the armor, then you have the sword, then you have thousands of people around you. So it was challenging, man. And you've been there, you've shot stuff, which is similar and you know how challenging that can get.
After my experience, I almost like swore I would never do that again.
You're never doing another sort of period horses,
no,
swords.
You get, the horse will have to be special effects.
Studio mein baith ke kursi ke upar.
But listen, you know there is one shot of yours,
which
I think is one of the best shots I've seen of any actor. I don't think they have retained that. I think it was in the teaser where it's just like it's that
right.
There's like wind on your hair and the hair is like
correct
amazing. I mean that is I was like dude this is something else. Now, I haven't seen you
thanks Rinal,
look,
thank you
look or be better than that ever.
Wow
yeah
that's and from that's from the first battle sequence.
Yeah, I think this is going to be at least your best work, for sure.
I am hoping.
Yeah, man. How long did you prep for it?
Well, what was it? You know, there was different kinds of prep. One was, of course, you know what I've realized, and you would know that is that when you're doing a film based on history, what is most important is to understand the people's mindset at that point of time. Because the things that you think are normal may not be normal at that point of time, and the things that you value, they might not value. So it's really about understanding their mindset. So I read lots of books about it about that time. Now the other thing that I had to do was, you know, I play a character, which is strange actually. It's almost like how many years we've known each other. I play a character that spans that amount of time. So it's like me being on 12th Road to me being now. You know what I mean? 12th Road, for those of you who don't know, is a place that we used to all hang out at when we were young. And it was a crazy place and we were a crazy bunch of people. We were like 12, 14 of us. So it's the character's arc sort of spans that amount of time. So I had to make a few changes in my voice for the younger character. I had to also physically be... I lost some weight for the younger character and I gained some weight for the older parts, and I made some changes in my voice.
What's the age that you play when you're older?
The age I play is 40, 43, 44.
And it starts when he's like?
He's about 20.
Wow.
21, yeah.
So you incorporated a change in your voice as well? For that.
A little bit, yeah. Thoda sa.
Thoda nahi, tune bahut kiya hoga.
नहीं बहुत तो नहीं किया थोड़ा बहुत किया थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस है और मुझे लगता है सबसे ज्यादा जो डिफरेंस है वो है प्रेजेंस में क्योंकि मुझे लगता है कि द ओल्डर यू ग्रो एंड द मोर कॉन्फिडेंट यू ग्रो about who you are and your decisions and stuff, the more your presence becomes more solid. So that was, I think, really important.
So, कुछ reviews हैं इसके. Have you read the reviews yet?
Reviews तो
reviews mind blowing.
बहुत अच्छे हैं.
Mind blowing. कुछ लोग बोल रहे हैं Magnum Opus, कुछ लोग बोल रहे हैं it's going to crash the OTT. Smash the OTT. कुछ लोग बोल रहे हैं epic है. तो
crash भी
feels good.
Crash भी, even if all the OTT platforms crash, it's good. Huh? I mean, as in crash, as in the server crashes. Huh?
मजा आ रहा है, मजा आ रहा है. I'm really happy about this show. Happy for you and the fact that, you know, it's this very, it's very, very exciting. You know?
Hi, I'm waiting for you to see it. I always get the best sort of, I get the most honest feedback actually from you. And I always have got the most honest feedback. So I'm waiting for you to see it to know what you think about it. It'll be fun.
So kab, when can we see it?
मुझे लगता है कि 27 अगस्त को तो रिलीज हो रहा है शो. उसके पहले हम लोग मुझे लगता है देख पाएंगे.
और ट्रेलर कब रिलीज हो रहा है? हो गया है आज.
ट्रेलर आज ही रिलीज हुआ है. हाँ, कुछ घंटे पहले.
अच्छा अच्छा, एक्साइटिंग डे.
हाउ वाज इट
फॉर द अदर एक्टर्स ऑन सेट?
वेल, यू नो व्हाट वाज अमेजिंग वाज वर्किंग विद शबाना आजमिया. Have you worked with Shabana ji? Have you done a film with her?
She is absolutely incredible. She's absolutely, absolutely incredible. How? What was your experience?
You've never done a film with her, no?
No.
Have I? No, it's amazing, yaar. I mean, no, you haven't. No. Amazing, because you know when you're acting with somebody like this, even when you're in the take, there's a part of you which is not the character, which is the actor in you.
Watching.
Which is looking at the other actor and watching and being like, wow, this is amazing. Or kabhi kabhi to, I mean, obviously you're, you know, when you're in the scene with her, you're there, but there were so many times and I wasn't needed for the scene, but I just wanted to go and watch her to see what she was doing, and she does it so incredibly well. It's amazing. Just one look, just one little smile, and you know, just conveys so much with that. And she's incredible fun to be around as well. I mean, she's just got so many wonderful stories, and she's lovely.
Many
so it was great fun shooting with her. Most of my work is, huh?
It's amazing when you have amazing actors on set and gets the best out of you.
Yeah, yeah.
So what
learn so, from?
So your character, what's that guy like? What's Babar like for you?
So Babar, ye jo show hai, it's based on a book by Alex Rutherford. It's called The Empire of the Mughals. This one's called Raiders from the North. Or it's what I found fascinating is that I had already read the book way before I was offered the show, and I always felt like this will make great content because it's like a fantasy fiction. You know, it's taken sort of real life events but also fictionalized them. So I always felt it'll make like a great movie or great content, and then you know it was something that came my way. What I found really fascinating about
it's
this
like
character,
you manifest-
I don't know if I manifested it, but
almost,
you know, I was like, I felt like this should be a show. And then Nikhil called me and said, I read this great book, I've got the rights, and you know, I want to make a show of it. And what I found really fascinating about this character was that he's physically strong, but emotionally weak. He's also a character that can be very, he's like, can be poetic, but can be very brutal as well. So there's a lot of opposites. And then it's also a character that is a king, but, you know, an emperor, but never really is sort of crippled by self-doubt. So never really knows whether, you know, he deserves it or doesn't deserve it. So there's a lot of like self-doubt. He's always constantly asking... Yeah. Whether I deserve this or not.
Yeah, I can see the layers. I can see the layers. It's so yeah. Interesting.
Yeah. And
because I mean, there is this part of him that that is coming across that is so powerful and so strong, And then, like you said, he is emotionally still doubting himself and finding, trying to find his way. So it's almost like a coming of age sort of journey, perhaps, that I'm assuming. I don't know.
Correct.
But these kind of journeys really, really are the best to watch. You know, where there is you can see the character growing through it, growing Correct. Through the journey. This he actually physically grows from a young age to the older man, right?
Correct.
Wow, that's amazing.
And the other thing that is really fascinating is that, you know, when you read a book like this, you realize how much power the women actually had. So you feel like, you know, it was all about the kings and the emperors, but it was actually a lot of the wives, the grandmothers, the mothers, you know, manipulating, pulling the strings, pushing the characters, the emperors in a certain direction very subtly. What you don't realize is that actually the women played a huge part in being kingmakers. So their power and their strength, I think that is something that is really fascinating. So all the women have really interesting characters, and they, you know, play really important parts in making the kings.
Wow, that is,
they are actually the kingmakers.
Yeah, that makes for some really interesting content. I can imagine the scenes. I can imagine these strong, powerful kings being like puppets in the hands of, you know. And you have some amazing actors, yeah, and all are looking really, really good. Dino's looking great. Pan asked me, of course, you know, the moment she comes on screen, you just feel like that impact. And
she's great.
The conviction. You are looking incredible.
Thank you.
Rahul Dev, Turan, Drishti. Amazing.
Drishti, all of them, yeah.
What was your toughest scene? Was it a physical one? Emotional one? What?
No, I think, physical, of course, when you're shooting, like I said, with like, you're shooting these war sequences, it's physically incredibly exhausting. But then when something goes wrong, he can just completely go the other way.
Who do you pick?
God, that's tough. That's a very tough one, man. The war sequences are mind-blowing. They're the scale at which they've been shot and how they're looking and how they've been conceived, I think, are very, very...
Okay.